गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 1 पार्ट 3, दैट इज एंजियोस्पर्म डाइवर्सिटी। सो सी हियर, द टर्म एंजियोस्पर्म हैज बीन डेरिव्ड फ्रॉम टू ग्रीक वर्ड्स। एंजियन मीन्स वेसल्स एंड स्पर्मा मीन्स सीड्स। द एंजियोस्पर्म्स आर द प्लांट्स विच अ सीड इनक्लोज्ड इन फ्रूट्स। The angiosperms constitutes an extremely diverse group of vascular plants. There are about 235,000 to 300,000 species. Another 500,000 species are estimated to be present on planet Earth, awaiting discovery. Angiosperms is a most recent group of plants to evolve in geological history, having made their probable first appearance 35 million years ago. Within a very short span of geological time, they have become the most dominant of all plant group because of their great evolutionary capabilities. Most of the food and other requirements for human came from angiosperms. The 235,000 to 300,000 species of angiosperm flowering plants are grouped in about 17,000 genera under about 200 to 260 families, depending on classification system. Orchidaceae with 25,000 to 35,000 and Asteraceae with 20,000 species are the largest families among angiosperms. Diversity in habit. Habit is an appearance of plant or how it grows at its growing places. Angiosperm shows the following types of habit diversity: herbs, shrubs, trees, climbers, twiners, creepers, runners, lianas, epiphytes, etc. So first we see herbs. It is a plant with weak, soft and green stem whose aerial portion is respectively short-lived, example coriander, cynodon, etc. Then shrubs, it is perennial woody plant with small height. It has many stems arising from ground level, example rose. Then tree, it is perennial woody plant with single large trunk. Mostly its height is more than the shrubs, example mango, neem, etc. Then climbers. This plant possesses long stem with diffused branches and special organs of attachment like tendrils, hooks, etc. by which it climbs on neighboring objects, example cucumber, pothos, money plant, etc. Twiner. It is a plant with a branched stem which itself twins around the supports and climbs, example Clitoria, Tinospora, Perdifolia, etc. Next, a creeper. This plant has weak stem, thus runs along with soil surface but do not have roots at nodal regions, example Rangoon creeper. Then next, that is runner. These plants are with special organs such as stolon offset and suckers, which produce new plants at specific intervals, example chrysanthemum, oxalis, etc. Then lianas, it is long woody perennial twiner, example entada, it is also called as woody climbers. Then epiphytes. The plants which grow on the other plants but do not absorb food from them, it's called as epiphytes. Okay, then we must see next point, that is habitat diversity. Habitat is the place where a particular plant can grow. The habitat diversity in angiosperm is determined by the various environmental factors such as water, soil, temperature, etc. In angiosperms, habitat diversity is of the following types: herbs, shrubs, trees, climbers. In angiosperms, habitat diversity is of the following types: number 1 hydrophytes, number 2 xerophytes, number 3 mesophytes, number 4 halophytes, etc. So first we see hydrophytes. These are the plants growing in water or soils saturated with water. Hydrophytes show morphological and anatomical adaptations, example hydrilla and nymphaea. Free floating hydrophytes, they float freely on water surface, example Lemna eucornea. Submerged floating, these plants are completely submerged under water and not rooted in the mud, example Najas. Rooted with floating leaves, roots of plants are fixed in mud but leaves are floating on the surface of water, example Nymphaea lotus. Rooted submerged, these plants are remaining completely submerged in water and are with rooted, Ceratophyllum hallucinaria. Rooted emergence, these plants are growing in soil saturated with water and with root systems, example Cyperus. Mesophytes, these plants are growing in soil with optimum conditions of water, example maize, sunflower. Third, xerophytes, these plants are growing in soil with scarcity of water. These are of following subtypes: ephemeral, non-succulent and succulent. So first we see ephemeral. These plants completed their life cycle within a short period to escape from drought condition. These are also called as a drought evenous plants, example Argemon mexicana, Borahia erecta. The non-succulent, these plants are drought resistant and hence may be referred as true xerophytes, example Nerium, Acacia, Casuarina, etc. Then halophytes, these are the plants growing in soil enriched with concentrated of salts like NaCl, MgSO4, etc. Example Rhizophora, Avicennia, etc. Okay. Then next point, that is diversity on the basis of nutrition. Diversity on the basis of nutrition. On the basis of mode of nutrition, angiosperms has grouped into four main types: autotrophic, parasites, insectivorous and saprophytes. Then autotrophic, these are the plants which prepare their own food material by the process of photosynthesis, example mango, maize, etc. Parasites. Parasitic angiosperms obtain their nourishments from other living plants, example that is host by means of special sucking roots termed as haustoria. The haustoria helps in penetration of tissues of parasites in host to make firm connection with the host vascular tissues. This connection helps to obtain ready-made food from phloem of host. Mineral salts and water is obtained from xylem by active transport mechanism. parasitic angiosperms are differentiated in following subtypes, such as total root parasites, total stem parasites, and cypriferous plants, saprophytic angiosperms. Total root parasites, some angiosperms are completely dependent on the roots of host on the plants for supplying of water, food, and mineral salts. These plants are called total root parasites. Example, Striga, Balanospora. In some total root parasites like Rafflesia, the flowers remain above the surface of the soil while the vegetative part is underground and parasite the roots of host. Example, Balanophora. Okay, then next, total stem parasites. The total stem parasite lack chlorophyll and do not have connections with soil after seedling stage, so that they are totally dependent on the host for supplying of water and mineral salts and organic food materials. Example, Cuscuta. Insectivorous parasites. These plants possess chlorophylls and therefore capable of manufactures of carbohydrates, but these plants cannot synthesize enough proteins as they grow in swampy soils, which is difficult in nitrogen, deficient in nitrogen. However, they can overcome this deficiency by catching smaller insects and digesting them. To fulfill these purposes, their leaves are modified variously. Okay, then last, that is saprophytic angiosperms. Some angiosperms which lack chlorophyll, they grow on soil rich in humus or dead organic matter in the forest. These plants obtain their nourishment from the humus or dead decaying organic matter through mycorrhizae. Example, Monotrepha nivotea. Okay, such as thus, biodiversity is also defined as the totality of gene species and the ecosystem of regions. The plant body is pteridophytes, is differentiated into two: root, stem, and leaves. It is a saprophytic process will develop vascular tissues. Okay, thank you.